I think I found my favorite portable 3D scanner. On paper, the Vega is a very promising tool, part of the new format of smartphone and camera-inspired scanners. Hi, I'm Elliot, and today, as part of the 3Dnatives lab, we're taking a look at Shining 3D's newest handheld 3D scanner, the Einstar Vega. The Einstar Vega, whose name you might partially recognize from the Einstar we reviewed over 2 years ago, is positioned as a mid-range portable 3D scanner with a strong emphasis on versatility and ease of use. Einstar has evolved from a single product to a whole sub-brand of Shining 3D, a Chinese company that has been developing 3D scanning solutions for nearly 2 decades. The company offers a wide range of products, from entry-level scanners in the Einstar series to high-precision metrology-grade systems in the FreeScan lineup, as well as dental scanners. Today, we'll focus exclusively on the Einstar Vega and see whether it deserves a spot in your toolbox. Let's dive right into our review. As soon as you get the Einstar Vega out of its carrying case, the build quality is immediately apparent. Unlike its more budget-friendly predecessor, the Einstar, the Vega is a standalone scanner, meaning it doesn't require being tethered to a cable, featuring a 6.4-inch touchscreen and a built-in 5000 mAh battery. Its chassis is made from aluminum and Gorilla Glass, giving it a premium, durable feel. At 180x95x26.5mm and weighing 535 grams, it remains compact and ergonomically designed. The form factor resembles a hybrid between a large modern point-and-shoot camera and a smartphone. Starting with the back of the device, you'll find a multi-sensor setup behind the glass panel. The Einstar Vega doesn't only come with one scan inside, but two. It uses both a MEMS scanner for HD scanning mode and a VCSEL-based system for fast scanning mode. These allow it to capture highly detailed scans in various lighting conditions. Integrated LEDs assist with color capture in low-light environments. For the tech-savvy, let's dive a bit deeper. The first technology included is MEMS, which stands for Micro-Electro-Mechanical Systems. MEMS uses microscopic mechanical mirrors to rapidly steer laser beams, capturing high-precision 3D data. MEMS scanners are known for their accuracy and fine detail resolution, making them ideal for intricate objects. Hence why this is a sensor used for HD mode, which is designed for smaller objects. On the other hand, VCSEL, or vertical cavity surface emitting lasers, are semiconductor-based laser emitters that project structured light patterns onto an object. The scanner then captures distortions in these patterns to generate 3D models. VCSEL scanners excel in speed and adaptability, especially for larger objects or challenging lighting conditions. By combining these two technologies, the Einstar Vega offers both high detail scanning for small objects and rapid scanning for larger ones, balancing precision and efficiency. On the front, the scanner has a 6.4-inch touchscreen, and along the bottom edge, you'll find a tripod mount and ventilation vents. A USB-C port for data transfer and charging is located on the left side of the device. In terms of internals, in addition to the sensors mentioned earlier, the Vega features 32GB of RAM, a 512GB SSD, and a 48MP camera for capturing texture information. Even though the Einstar Vega is an investment at just under $2,000, when you take into account that this device is essentially a mini computer with a touchscreen on the back, two 3D scanners, and a custom UI, it almost sounds like a bargain. The onboard display provides real-time feedback while scanning, making it easier to maintain optimal scanning distance and avoid tracking loss. The operating system runs a custom UI which, you can tell, was made for touchscreen interactions. Scans made with the Einstar Vega can be exported in STL, OBJ, PLOI and ASC file formats, ensuring compatibility with a wide range of CAD and slicing software. Once the scan is done with the scanner, you can either post-process and convert the point cloud on the device itself, or use the Star Vision software, which offers an all-in-one solution for post-processing point clouds, generating meshes and exporting 3D models on a computer. For transferring data from the scanner to a PC, you can either use the included USB-C cable or upload files wirelessly to the Shining 3D cloud. The scanner comes with 5GB of free cloud storage, allowing for remote access. The Vega comes with a protective cover, which comes in handy for easy handling. The scanner can also be mounted on a tripod or held with a small foldable tripod provided. Some users have already modeled cases with external side grips that you can 3D print. In my opinion, using the Vega feels a lot like using a modern smartphone app. The experience is intuitive and even beginners should get by easily. Some settings initially lacked descriptions, but a recent update addressed this and also added a few welcome improvements, like support for different marker sizes for each mode as well as wireless casting to an external display. As mentioned earlier, the Einstar Vega offers two scanning modes, HD for small detailed objects and fast for large objects. In my testing, it performed well across various scenarios, from scanning small objects like the figurine provided with the scanner to scanning a large object like my sofa, the Einstar Vega was able to capture all the details I wanted to reproduce. I also used Vega to scan people and even got myself scanned in the process. In fact, I was scanned by someone who had never used a 3D scanner before. And as she zoomed around me, the scanner was able to create a surprisingly good scan. Thanks to auto white balance and exposure, plus the built-in LED lights, the colors also looked quite realistic. One of the standout features of the Einstar Vega is its portability. Since it runs on an internal battery, I was able to scan objects anywhere without being tethered to a power source or computer.
Using the Einstar Vega, I was able to capture all the detail from this statue and turn it into a mesh in a few minutes. I also scanned the motorbike, which features dark black parts and reflective surfaces. Surprisingly, the Vega performed really well. Even though some details were missing in the reflective parts, I was really pleasantly surprised with the end result.
To truly put the Vega through its paces, I decided to create some tricky situations. First, I tried scanning a drill without applying any scanning spray. This was particularly challenging since the drill has deep plastic parts, reflective metal surfaces, and a lot of intricate details. While the scanner managed to capture most of the drill, it struggled with very dark or reflective surfaces. These challenges are common to all laser and structured light scanners and can easily be solved by applying a coat of scanning spray. Second, I tried scanning my sofa in one go. The results were mixed. On one hand, the fast mode worked well for capturing the crease fabric and pillows. On the other hand, scanning the bottom of the sofa required including the carpet in the scan to help with tracking. Scanning the back of the sofa was another challenge. Without a textured surface or distinct features, the scanner struggled. This could easily be solved by using markers or placing a non-uniform blanket over the sofa to add more visual reference points. Other than those particularly tricky tests, my experience was very straightforward and the scanner performed well. Sometimes, if you move too fast or scan tricky objects, the scanner can get lost. When this happens, a notification will appear to warn you that it lost tracking and for you to go back to a previously scanned section. To achieve a decent result without using any markers or additional visual references, I had to do multiple scans as I quickly reached the maximum frame limit. However, this virtual limit has since been increased through an over-the-air update. Despite an overall smooth experience, one feature I truly missed was the ability to align scans directly on the scanner. At least for now, this requires using the computer software, meaning complex multi-angle scans can't be processed on the go without also carrying a laptop. Since this scanner is also targeted at beginners, I think it could benefit from more guidance, perhaps a tutorial mode covering different object types and scanning techniques. That being said, Shining 3D has some great tutorial videos on YouTube, and since the scanner is basically a mini PC, these could easily be accessible on the device itself. Visually, with its protective case on, the Einstar Vega kind of reminds me of a VTech KiddyZoom camera, but it would be the grown-up evolution with significantly better build quality and a far more sophisticated touchscreen interface. Shining 3D has done an excellent job of making this scanner both powerful and accessible. The combination of its dual scanning technologies, onboard touchscreen and standalone functionality make it a compelling choice for engineers, designers and 3D printing enthusiasts alike. At just under $2,000, the Einstar Vega is a pricey option for personal use. But with its ease of use and capabilities, it feels like a bargain, especially for service bureaus and industrial companies. Even some makers will find it very useful. So, if you're looking for a versatile, portable 3D scanner that delivers high-quality results without needing a constant PC connection, the Einstar Vega is a strong contender. Though, do keep in mind that the Vega isn't a metrology scanner, but its performance is sufficient enough for any common 3D printing application. After a few weeks of testing and scanning pretty much anything we came across, we rated the Einstar Vega with our usual criteria, giving it a final score of 9.8 out of 10. To see how we calculated this score, you can read our written article here. To discover all 3D printers tests we have done, click here. That wraps up our review. If you have any questions, drop them in the comments below. If you want to watch more 3D printing related content, you're in the right place. Be sure to check out our other videos. See you next time in the 3Dnatives lab, and until then, happy printing!